Caslibs are new with SAS Viya. In this short video, we'll take a brief look at what a Caslib is. A Caslib is how the CAS server accesses data. At its simplest, the Caslib is just a container. The container has two areas where data is referenced, the source data or files, and an in-memory space that makes the data available for CAS processing. The container also holds connection information for the source data and access controls governing who can access the Caslib and what they can do with it. In this example, the connection is to a path on the file system on the CAS controller machine. In other cases, a Caslib could access a database and would then contain connection information such as the password, the schema information, and the data source type. The access controls, which are also part of the Caslib, dictate what groups and individual users are authorized to do with the contents of the Caslib. To process the data in CAS, the data must be lifted into memory. At this point in our diagram, the data2 SAS HDAT file has been lifted into memory to the table data2 and is available for analysis and reporting in CAS. Additional tables can be lifted into memory from the Caslib's data source. In addition, data can be loaded to the Caslib's in-memory space from areas other than the Caslib's source path. Using this technique, you can load local CSV files or SAS datasets into CAS. The Caslib, now that we're looking at, has three in-memory tables available for analytic processing within CAS. If we don't need tables anymore, they can be dropped from memory. If we make changes to an in-memory table, they can be saved back to the Caslib's data source so that the changes are available the next time you load the Caslib. That has been a brief explanation of Caslibs. To summarize, a Caslib is a container for source and in-memory data. All data is available to CAS through Caslibs, and all operations in CAS that use data are performed with a Caslib in place. Thank you for watching, and check back later for more tips and tricks.